So welcome to this first lecture in the fourth theme on architectural knowledge, focus on architecture patterns. The theme is the first step towards obtaining more hands-on knowledge on how to design your architectures. The theme comes in three lectures. This introduction is the first, but then we have three focused lectures on patterns and reference architectures, and a final lecture with a short example on how to use patterns in a design situation. So moving on, architecture design is a critical activity, obviously, but if you try to structure architecture design into some distinct steps, there is a first step that focuses on the architectural significant requirements. We've been through that in one of the previous themes, but when the architect faces an ASR, well, they are expected to find a design that addresses the concerns expressed in the requirement. But in order to do that, well, they have to start looking for options for their architecture decisions that should address then the requirement. But where do you find these options? Well, that's a common question, and not always easy to answer. But knowledge comes in different formats. The most obvious one is, of course, the architect and the architect's own experience. They have been in the business for quite some time. They have learned from their successes and their failures. Of course, they know what used to work and what didn't work. But besides this internal knowledge in the group of architects, there is something that is externalized, knowledge that others have externalized, written down in books, in papers, in different formats. And it's in this class you find the patterns, you find the tactics, and you find reference architectures. The third source of knowledge is other systems. There is most often, or I should say always, a similar system out there that you can look at, that you can study, and you can find different options for your decisions. And the decisions you make are, of course, based on the knowledge you have. So the more time you invest in finding knowledge, eliciting knowledge about, well, the current ASR and providing options for your decision making, the better you're off. At the end of the day, well, your decisions are represented in views, and this completes the design process. But if you turn back to knowledge, well, there is a nice little analogy that you can make. And if you look at the game of chess, there are a couple of steps, distinct steps that you will pass on your path towards becoming a master. First, of course, you have to learn the basic rules and the physical constraints, the board geometry, orientation, the different pieces, how you can move them, etc. And when you have learned these basic rules and constraints, well, you can move on and learn the basic principles. And the basic principles is when you introduce some strategy into your game. So which pieces are more valuable than others, which positions on the board are more valuable, etc. But you will not become a master just from learning these rules and these principles. In order to master something, to master the game of chess, you have to study games of other masters or games of masters, because in these games you will find patterns. So their decisions in certain situations, in certain contexts, and the consequences of these decisions. And obviously, since the game of chess has been around for a long time, there are hundreds, thousands of these games and these patterns. Four different phases of the game: opening the game, closing the game, etc. So, to become master of chess, well, you have to go through these steps. And if you try to make the same story for software design or software architecture design, you have the basic rules, you have the basic principles, but in order to become a true master of software design, you have to learn the patterns. And of course, well, there are thousands, millions of software systems out there, and there are lots of design patterns, architecture patterns, patterns at various levels of abstraction that you can learn. And by doing that, you will become a better software designer. So architectural knowledge is a collection of various types of information about design options at the architectural level and the consequences of these options. So similar to a design pattern, but at the architectural level. And we also have other types of knowledge, reference architectures and tactics. And an architecture tactic, if you wonder what that is, the illustration here is a gameplay. So an instruction for how to conduct a certain action. And an architecture tactic can be a regular pattern, can be an architecture pattern, but it can also be more specific behavior. We will come back to this in the next theme. In this theme, we focus on reference architectures and architecture patterns. An architecture pattern is, in a similar way as a design pattern, something that solves or addresses a recurring problem. So it's a template for how to structure or organize your architecture elements. Typically, they provide a set of predefined subsystems with responsibilities, but also the rules, the guidelines, well, the constraints for how to organize the elements and the relationships in between the elements. So as you will see, architecture patterns have a lot in common with regular software design patterns. A reference architecture is a model that try to outline a complete system. So in this picture here, for instance, we have the Usher IoT reference architecture. So architecture elements, their responsibilities and their organization that are required when you build IoT applications using the Usher architecture. We also have AWS in the middle for a traditional Microsoft SQL Server reference architecture. You can look into these and you will see that there are various components that are required. There are descriptions for how they relate to others, and also a dynamic description for what's happening in various stages of the application. And the Department of Defense, DOD, the U.S. Department of Defense, they use this definition of a reference architecture, that it's an authoritative source of information about a specific subject area that guides and constrains the instantiations of multiple architectures and solutions. So it guides and constrains multiple implementations. So if you look at the Azure IoT, for instance, that reference architecture is valid for all Azure IoT applications. And the Amazon web application hosting on the right-hand side, that's valid for all web applications hosted in the Amazon infrastructure. So a reference architecture provides the architects with a head start. So you need this if you want to build an application like this. And it means that you don't have to sit down and spend too much time figuring things out. If you design a system for a specific infrastructure, the descriptions you can get from the provider of that infrastructure can give you a head start. And well, then we have the tactics, and the tactics, recipes to achieve quality, I call them. And as I said, patterns can be one such recipe, but it's more common to find tactics that are really focusing on functionality in the system. So responsibilities that you allocate to elements in your system, and if you make these elements cooperate in a certain way using a certain protocol, you can achieve certain qualities. So in this example, if you imagine that you want to construct a garage door that is automatic, you can look up a tactic. This is not software related, but the principle is the same. You need to build or design a garage door opener that is able to detect obstacles and then react to that. And the tactic provide you recipe, the elements you need, the responsibilities for these elements, and how they should interact. So that was the introduction to architecture knowledge, focus on patterns and reference architectures. And now we move on to the remaining three lectures.